in Colorado history to have a baby during session.
Welcome to the floor of the Colorado State Senate, where history has always been on the agenda.
You believe we're starting up again?
But until now, Colorado hasn't seen this kind of history.
I'm due in 3 weeks.
Indeed, when the General Assembly starts Wednesday morning, Senator Brittany Patterson's baby watch will be in full effect.
We don't have any rules around what to do if somebody is having a baby.
But surprisingly, the body trying to pass paid family leave for the entire state is still struggling to figure out what to do with the senator when she goes out on maternity leave and when she comes back.
My pay might get docked.
As of right now, Patterson isn't sure she'll get paid. She'd have to be classified as having a chronic illness. And when she does return, right now, she won't be able to easily breastfeed.
We've been told that you can't bring your children on the floor.
The good news for Patterson is Senate leaders are trying to figure this out.
We're looking at everything. I mean, this is a new area we have not experienced.
Senator Leroy Garcia is president of the Senate, and he's trying to amend rules so Patterson gets her paycheck. One rule that will be impossible to change for the moment is the constitutional requirement that senators vote in person. Majority Leader Steve Finberg says some bills may be delayed.
We will at times move a vote to a different day, maybe when Senator Patterson can be there.
So in short, the body which immortalizes plenty of old white men is having to change, just like every other workplace. Senator Patterson says she won't be the last to have a baby.
We have more young women running and winning.
The Jefferson County Democrat tells me she initially thought she might only be able to be gone for about 2 weeks, but in talking with the other mothers, she thinks she may need some more time. She'll be on standby for any emergency votes. Live at the Capitol, Joe St. George, Fox 31.